Welcome to Recipes for Life. I'm Dr. Beth, and for today's show, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite ingredients, which is flax. I love flax because it's very high in two components that are very hard to get enough of in our diet. These are fiber and omega-3 fatty acids. First, I want to tell you about the foods we're going to make. We're going to make brownies with flax, and also we're going to make a pizza crust out of flax. So before we do that, I want to tell you how to purchase flax. When you purchase flax, you want to buy it in seed form. You do not want to buy your flax mill, which is already ground, because when you grind the flax, those very sensitive omega-3 fatty acids actually start to break down. And when you are purchasing flax that's been milled, you could be purchasing flax that has already gone rancid. So it will taste bad and it will smell bad, and that is not what flax is about. Now, when you're storing your flax at home, I simply have it in a container right on my cabinet. You do not need to refrigerate it. The nutrients are protected inside the shell as long as it's in its whole seed form. You can purchase, you'll see brown or golden. It's really a matter of personal choice. I prefer the golden because I actually feel it has a even milder taste than the brown. And but you could, both are equally nutritious. You can either choose the brown or the golden seed. You can also purchase flaxseed oil capsules, which will give you the benefit of the omega-3 fatty acids. So you could take this as a supplement to help get those omega-3s into your diet. And you can also purchase the fiber, there's a special fiber in flax called lignans. And these lignans actually have lots of research showing that they're very anti-cancer, but they're also good for the digestive system, and they have many other health benefits. And you can purchase the lignin component, which has the fatty acids removed and all the other nutrients, so you're just getting the lignin, so that is another option. You can find many foods. Flax is very versatile. You can find many different foods that contain flax. These are some flax crackers that I made, and typically you do not want to consume the seeds whole unless they've been soaked. Now, these were soaked in water for about 6 hours. That softens the shell so the body can actually break them down so you can get the nutrients out of the seeds. So for our brownies, we're taking really a basic brownie recipe that you would typically use a regular flour, and we're substituting the flour with ground flax. You can do that with a lot of recipes, and I do recommend that the first time that you try that with a recipe, that you start with half flax, and then you can use half of your regular flour. And if that works great, you know, the next time you could actually try 100% flax instead of the flour. And recipes like this, it works great. And if the batter does get too thick, what you would do is simply add a little bit extra water. And this can happen because there is so much fiber in the flax that it really absorbs the water out of the batter, and it can make it really thick. No problem, just add a little bit more liquid. So for this recipe, we're starting with 1 stick of organic butter, and we're gonna start out just by creaming it. So once you get your butter softened, we're gonna add the next ingredient, which is 1 cup of raw honey. And the original recipe did call for 1.5 cups sugar. And of course, honey is sweeter than sugar, so we can reduce it to 1 cup. And then we are gonna add a little bit of stevia at the end. And if you have, say, a diabetic in the house that you don't want them eating this much honey, you can actually reduce the honey significantly and simply use more stevia. So then we cream that together. And then our next ingredients are going to be 4 room temperature eggs and the vanilla. So I'm going to go ahead and add the vanilla first. And we actually want a tablespoon of vanilla. And the eggs I'm going to add one at a time. Now, if you have a stand mixer, you could absolutely use a stand mixer, but for the sake of the show, it's just going to be easier for you to see what I'm doing with this mixer. So, mix it. Number 3. Scrape down my sides just to make sure I'm getting all the butter in there. And our next ingredient is a teaspoon of salt, and I'm using a natural sea salt that's been unbleached. Give that a stir. And our next ingredient is the flax. So I'm going to set that aside and show you how I grind my flax. So we're going to need 2 whole cups. And my grinder's not quite big enough to do the 2 cups, so we'll have to do it in sections. And you just hold the grinder down for probably 5 to 7 seconds, that's it. So, there's your ground flax. I'm just gonna dump it in my measuring cup. And that gives us just under a cup. So our 2 cups of ground flax goes right into the batter. And I like to add it half at a time. So I'm gonna get my sides again. Are ready to add. We need 1/2 cup of cocoa powder plus a heaping tablespoon. So we'll just do this right over the bowl. So there's our 1/2 cup, and then we need an extra heaping tablespoon. So, then we need a tablespoon of baking powder. And I get the non-aluminum kind. So, we'll mix that in. starting to look like brownies now. And it sure smells like chocolate in here. Okay, we just have a couple more ingredients. Get those sides again. Make sure you're getting everything on the bottom in there. And, all right, next ingredient is we're gonna add a half a cup of water, which I've already measured. And then we're gonna add 1/2 cup of organic half and half. So I'm just gonna add that so we have a full cup of liquid. There we go. Pour that in. I don't want that to splatter, so I'm gonna start it by hand. Okay, so now if you wanted, you could add walnuts, you could add chocolate chips, you could add coconut, whatever you like to have in your brownies. I kind of like them plain. So I'm gonna get our pan that's been buttered. And also, you might want to give it a taste to see if it's at the right sweetness level for you. Actually, I think they're plenty sweet. If they were not sweet, this is when I would add a little bit of stevia, but I really think they're just fine. So we're gonna go ahead and put this into our 9x13 glass pan that's been buttered. And it's gonna go into a preheated oven at 350 degrees. And they're gonna bake for 35 minutes. And you kinda wanna watch them. You don't wanna overbake your brownies because they can get dried out. So you wanna watch that. Just make sure that batter's even. And they are ready to go in the oven. So we'll set our timer.
The Cancer Fighter's Kit from Dr. Beth, featuring Recipes for Life cookbook, the book Phytonutrient, medicinal nutrients found in food, the book pH, optimal health through alkaline foods, mushroom immune defense book, Chlorella, ultimate green food book, 30 count of pH test strips, and a 300 count bottle of Chlorella. $91.75 value, all for $75. Or without the Chlorella supplement for only $49.95. Go online or call today.
So before we move on to the pizza, while our brownies are baking, I want to go over some of the health benefits of flax. And the first one is something that I recommend to my patients all the time, is that by incorporating flax into your diet every day, you can actually lower your cholesterol and also your triglyceride levels. Another benefit is a healthier blood pressure. And now some of the benefits are because of the fiber and the omega-3 benefits combined. Some are just because of the fiber, some are just because of the omega-3. Now for the fiber, for example, helps us feel full, so we eat less. Fiber is very important for digestion and maintaining regularity and reducing constipation, and also helps us with weight loss because of the fact that it helps us eat less because it does make us feel full. And finally, the fiber in flax, there's two types. There's a soluble and an insoluble. And they both have different benefits, but probably most important to me is the lignans. I showed you the lignin product earlier. This product has been shown in research to help actually protect us against several types of cancer, including colon cancer and hormonally related cancers such as prostate and breast. The benefits of the omega-3 are even more lengthy. Deficiencies of omega-3 fatty acids include eczema, dry, itchy skin, disorders of the retina, which is the eye, depression, memory loss, ADD, ADHD, bipolar, schizophrenia, anger disorders, and many other problems associated with the brain, because the omega-3s are an absolutely critical nutrient for good brain health. And then, of course, the inflammatory disorders. Omega-3 fatty acids are needed for the body to make anti-inflammatory prostaglandins. So if you do not have enough omega-3s in your diet, you are very likely to suffer a number of inflammatory problems, such as arthritis, tendonitis, colitis, and any other condition that ends with itis is actually an inflammatory disorder. It's also helpful for Crohn's and other digestive issues. And inflammation is also associated with heart disease, high cholesterol, high triglycerides, and even high blood pressure. So you can see the importance of incorporating this simple food into your diet. So let's get started on our pizza. So to make our flax pizza crust, what we're gonna do is grind 2/3 cup of flax. And now, see how close I got. So that goes in there. And then we're gonna add 3 tablespoons of, I'm using an organic corn meal. And we need 3 tablespoons. If you don't wanna use corn, which is very inflammatory, you could also use almond meal. And then we're gonna add 1/4 cup of a high quality grated Parmesan cheese, 1 egg, and I think it's 1 tablespoon Italian seasoning. And 1/2 teaspoon sea salt. And we're gonna need a little bit of water, but I'm gonna mix this together first. All right, so I'm gonna grab the water. And I'm going to start with 2 tablespoons. And then if we need to add another, we can add another. We just need enough to help bind it together. Okay. So this needs to sit aside for about 5 minutes to rest. And the water binds everything all together like a glue, and then it will be ready for us to put out on our pan. So in the meantime, while that's resting, we're gonna make our sauce, and need that. We'll start with a clove of garlic, and I know that you can buy your own pizza sauce. So you don't have to go through this step. You can just pour it out but I like to make my own. So you want to chop this fine. All right, so that goes in there. And then I like to use organic tomato paste. Hopefully I can open this. And I like to get my paste in a jar rather than a can. Or something. Get it out of there. And a little bit of olive oil. A little bit of sea salt, about a half a teaspoon is plenty, and about a tablespoon, well, I'd say a teaspoon of Italian seasoning. And of course, a little bit of cayenne pepper. You can add as much or as little as you like. We like a lot, so I'm putting in a lot. And we just need to stir that. And that is it. Doesn't take long at all to make your very own pizza sauce from scratch. And we are ready to make our crust. The dough has rested and it is glued together quite nicely. So what we're gonna do is make sure you have clean hands and oil your pan. And you can also take a little bit of that cornmeal and spread it on the bottom. So we're going to take our dough. And we're just going to squish it out onto the pan. And you know, keep your edges together so they don't spread apart. But it needs to be pretty thin. So you just kind of have to work at it until it gets to the thinness and the shape that you want. I'm not even sure if I'm going to do a round or a square, but as I push it out, I just like to keep the push the edges in so it doesn't spread apart. And you just keep working at it, pushing from the middle out. If it starts to stick, you might want to grab the olive oil. Just get a little bit more on your fingers. And this is going to go in the oven at 375 degrees for about 12 minutes. Then we're going to take it out and put our toppings on. And then it's going to go back in the oven for 15 more minutes, 12 or 15 more minutes. Whenever the cheese starts to get brown, then you'll know it's done. So this is just about done. And we're ready to put our toppings on. And I like to put provolone right on the top here because it helps as a moisture barrier from when we put our tomato sauce on. You can obviously use whatever kind of toppings you like. Mushrooms, onions, you know, there's so many choices you can put in your pizza. So next we're gonna put on our sauce. And of course this just needs to be a thin layer. And next I'm going to put on our little sausage pieces. It's so much easier to cut when it's frozen. You can make them so much thinner. And our green bell pepper. which I put through the mandolin. Make them nice and thin. And then our red jalapenos. I used two of them because they're really not very hot, we don't think. So then we like to add a little bit of spinach. And of course, spinach melts down to just nothing. So it might look like you're adding a lot, but by the time it cooks down, it doesn't seem like a lot at all. All right. Top it off with our cheese. We like a lot of cheese. And then at the very top, just a little bit of Parmesan. The same stuff as we used in the crust. All right, it's ready to go in. And remember, your plate's hot, so you wanna use your heating pad to put it right back in the oven. So our pizza's out of the oven. It smells great, it looks great. I can't wait to eat it. I've already tasted the brownies and actually they're really good. So thanks for joining us today. I hope you learned something new that you did not know about flax. Flax is something I've been interested in for a long, long time. I've actually written two books about flax, Flax Fabulous Flax and Flax Lignans. They're both available on the website, www.blpublications.com. They do contain lots of flax recipes and ways to use flax. You can mix it into peanut butter and eat it with celery. You can put it in your yogurt smoothies. There are so many ways that you can easily just boost your daily intake of flax. All you need is 2 to 3 tablespoons. If you've never had flax, I recommend you start with just 1 tablespoon of ground flax a day and work your way up to 2 or 3. And that way you'll be getting those omega-3s and that fiber that is most likely missing in your diet, because it is missing in the diets of so many people today. So again, thanks for joining us. I wish God's blessings upon your day and your health.